It's funny how in North America, pop is kind of seen as a dirty word.
So many different subsidiaries of pop.
I love pop music. If you wanna be my lover, you have got to give. Taking is too easy, but that's the way it is. If you wanna be my lover,
you gotta make it last forever. Well, pop music's the only music in the whole world that no matter who you are, where you come from, where you live, when that one pop song comes on, it just moves anyone, anywhere in the world. It's got that magical, visceral power.
What if, when you're in a mood, when you feel sad and stuck and too many things to count, it's just more therapeutic to write down someone else's words than your own? The only thing that made me feel better was writing down quotations from stuff I'd read or advice people gave me. My own words were no comfort, but writing out the lyrics to Disappear by Beyonce was like the greatest release I could have hoped for.
There's a lot of benefits to being a fangirl and being a fan of anything. One is the community that you're part of, and you feel connected to something at a time in your life when you almost don't really care about anything.
I think fandom is interesting that it does allow multiple groups of people from different racial and class backgrounds to come together.
I remember going to see Avril Lavigne play. That was like the first like big show, and like I wore black eyeliner and I wore a tie, and I went to the show and there were like thousands of other girls wearing ties and black eyeliner. And I wasn't allowed to see the openers because they were too non-religious. So I had to like sit outside and like peek through the thing while Smash Mouth played, and then when they were done, then I was allowed to go in. And it was like my first big concert, and just being like, oh, all these other people listen to this like same song, you know, and just realizing like the power that that had.
I think Pink is one of the greatest mainstream feminist singers out there at this time. Also, yes, there are issues with Pink, but there's something that I love about her newest album, Truth About Love, that she kind of breaks that societal stereotype of what it means to be in love, and that love isn't this Disney fantasy. But I hate you, I really hate you so much, I think it must be true love, true love, it must be true. But also, I love her song, Walk of Shame, and that one need not be afraid or ashamed of one's sexuality, whether that be homosexuality, heterosexuality, or anything in between or outside. That, you know, yeah, I'm walking home because I just hooked up with a random, and I will never have a walk of shame again because I'm not ashamed of it.
Music is really important, I think, in mainstream culture too, is because they're not just songs, they're not just like words, they are things we repeat to ourselves and dance to and sing, and our children hear, and they become like the narratives of our culture. So if, like, you know, feminism is going to change the way that people treat women, treat their wives and their friends and the people around them, if we're gonna have equality, then like I think music leads that in a lot of ways.
So this little I'm just a fan thing is not to be taken as playing the underdog, because here's the thing, fangirling is not purely about the subject of your fandom. It's actually almost entirely a reflection of you.
I think the internet, I think social networking in particular, is a real vital tool these days for young girls who are basically taking their fandom and taking the idea that their fandom is not welcome, and really doing quite productive stuff with this and making, you know, good bonds with each other, and, you know, finding ways together to kind of counteract the damage of those who would make fun of them, or or call them responsible for bad culture. I think that they are, you know, there's ways that they can that sort of fandom has always been able to be powerful.
Yeah, I think there is a really important role for popular culture and fandom to play with activism. I think it's essential because it really is influential. And for people to kind of say, oh, it doesn't matter what this celebrity does or that celebrity, I think they're really discounting a lot of really big impacts that people can make.
The highest calling, the supreme being, is a fan, is the person who is open and wants to love things and wants to feel connected. I'm beautiful.